Hi guys, so on this episode of Is It Fire with Yvette Aguirre, we are reviewing the Stay Naked Urban Decay foundation and concealer. Is it gonna work? Am I gonna like the shade? Am I gonna like the formula? Stay tuned. Okay, so first things first is we're gonna prime. I typically don't prime. I just don't feel like it has ever really done much to me. My philosophy is that primer and setting spray are just a placebo, but we are going to prime today. So today the primer I'm using is the Too Faced Hangover Primer. It smells like coconut. So my skin lately has not been the best. I haven't been wearing makeup, so you would think that it'd be like good, but it hasn't, and it's fine. So now I'm gonna move on to doing my brows. I will do these off camera just cause they take me a while, so we will be right back. We are primed. I have done my eyebrows off camera. If you guys want a tutorial on my eyebrows, please let me know. I also tend to, I used to do them myself with like Nair and stuff and shape them, but now I go to Elizabeth and I will link down her business. So usually for my eyebrows, what I tend to do next is I always use the concealer that I'm using that day. So we are going to test out the Stay Naked Correcting Concealer up to 24 hour wear. I got it in the shade 40NY, which is light, medium, neutral, yellow. The only thing that kind of sucked is because these are so popular right now, I had to go to Sephora to get one, and then I had to go to Ulta to get the other one. Or they had it, my shade in one place for one thing, but not the other, so I had to go to a different place. And usually I like to go to Ulta instead as much as I can, just because their reward system is obviously a lot better than Sephora, in my opinion. I don't make use of any of the little sample things that they give at Sephora. And when I was there, I was like, just out of curiosity, like, how many points do I have? And she's like, girl, you got 1,000. And I was just like, what can I do with 1,000? And she's like, you can pick all the samples you want. And I was like, bish bye. Here we have the Stay Naked. It's weightless liquid foundation. It's texture. It's for texture. Okay, let's see. Last 12 months. Cool beans. That's usually kind of the typical 12 or 24, depending. So my foundation that I chose was 51 warm yellow. And this is medium shade intensity. So I'm gonna use it to conceal my eyebrows. Handle wet, dirty. Yep. So let's see. And it has a pump. I like pumps. Who doesn't like pumps? And let's see. Does it have a smell? Let's see that. No, it just smells kind of like paint, but not in a really, not in a bad way. Let's see, a Morphe M444 brush on this end. This is quite light. I mean, I will say if you like light concealers or concealers, foundations that are lightweight and breathable, this is probably your go-to or could be your go-to. I'm just more used to super full coverage, which I mean, I should have saw that this was advertised more as a medium and not so much of a full coverage. It's probably buildable, but let's see. And I try not to put too much foundation on my nose. Okay. And now, let's try another pump. Like I said, this is very lightweight, so I wouldn't be too worried about adding another layer. Just because it's very breathable, like I said. Are you guys more of a brush kind of person or a sponge kind of person? Let me know in the comments. And then I'll use a beauty, or not a beauty blender, but I'll use a sponge for this side. I haven't used a sponge in so long. The only thing I tend to use sponges for are for my concealer. Yeah, but I'm not feeling it with the sponge. Let's see. I'm just gonna have to. I feel like I've just absorbed it all, you know? Okay. Let's talk about my thoughts on the foundation. The foundation's okay. I'm used to more. The foundation's okay. I'm used to more of full coverage. I should have been new. But what really intrigued me is the 24-hour wear. I'm like, okay, let's see what this is about. And also, just a new formula, you know. I tend to stick to my usual full coverage foundation, which is the Huda Beauty, and lately I was just like, oh, I want to try something different, so that's why I tried this one. But yeah, it looks good though. So now we're going to try the concealer. And I already said the shade, which was 40NY. And let's see. Does this have a scent? No, not really. And I like to put it, like most people, right here. Oh, I really like the applicator. That's a really cute applicator. And I use, like, using the the kind of like angled part of the sponge, like this part. I don't know. A lot of people are like using the other side. I mean, Huda Beauty's $40, Born This Way Foundation's $40, this is $40. It's the same price. I'm going to do the rest of my face, then I will come back. All right guys, so I just threw on the rest of my face routine, and my final thoughts are, is it fire? Is it not fire? I personally think that, is it fire? Is it not fire? Well, let's take a closer look at what we're seeing on my face. I feel like the concealer didn't really, I mean, I don't have much to conceal, and I'm not trying to be cocky about it at all, but like, I don't have like super dark under eye circles or anything, or any, like all I have is freckles, and I feel like right here, I feel like I still see some stuff going on. As I'm used to super matte, super full coverage all day, don't have to touch it. I just don't feel like this is for me. However, I do feel like for people who find it hard to find something that makes them look like still themselves, I mean, no shit, we all want to look like ourselves, but who don't want something too caked on, then I feel like in that case, this is totally for you, and I totally recommend it. Just because I feel like your natural skin still glows through if you allow it to. Again, I added layer after layer, right? On both sides, not just one. What I will say is it was really easy to work with. I literally did my makeup in like less than half an hour, and it's like boom, fine. So it's really easy, it's really buildable. And it's true to color, and it doesn't oxidize, which is awesome. Congrats, Urban Decay, you did really good. So I feel like Urban Decay did really good on this foundation. It's just not for me, but it could be for you. So this one's a hard one. So again, for Is It Fire with Yvette Aguirre, this one is not for me. This is my review on the Urban Decay Stay Naked Foundation and Concealer. If you have any questions, please leave them down below. And if you have any suggestions that or things you would like to see, also please put them down below. And thank you so much for watching. It has been Is It Fire with Yvette Aguirre. Until next time. Ooh, get down.